Blessings in Disguise. Unveiling the Hidden Gifts in Life's Challenges. Author, Deb Lamperd. Narrated by Deb Lamperd. Copyright 2024, Deb Lamperd. Dedication for Mum, 1938 to 2024. For Tanya, Sam and Bill, my blessings in disguise. Introduction. Welcome to the threshold of a transformative journey, a portal into the realm of blessings in disguise. As you turn these pages, allow yourself to entertain the possibility that the universe, in its infinite wisdom, has orchestrated the arrival of this book into your hands at precisely this moment in your life. It is an invitation, a gentle nudge from the cosmos to guide you back to the profound remembrance of your true spiritual essence and purpose. Blessings in Disguise is not merely a book. It is a sanctuary of revelations born of my own pilgrimage through the landscapes of the soul, a journey that found its genesis on January 7th, 2008. This pivotal day marked the end of an 18-year marriage, heralding the onset of a profound personal upheaval characterized by post-traumatic stress disorder, depression, and bipolar disorder. The ensuing 5 years became a passage through the shadows, necessitating guidance of both a psychiatrist and psychologist as I endeavoured to navigate the uncharted territories of this newfound existence. My background as a police officer of 26 years, with its reservoir of suppressed traumas, compounded the complexity of this transformation. Additionally, the mantle of motherhood to two boys, then aged 12 and 10, cast its own unique light and shadows upon the path, intensifying the emotional landscape of this period of change. It was in this crucible of transformation that the poems within this book were conceived, whispers of the soul captured in moments of solitude and communion with the universe. These verses flowed forth in the quiet hours before dawn, under the canopy of the night sky, as I sought solace and understanding in the silent dialogue with the cosmos. Blessings in Disguise, the poem that lent its name to this compilation, emerged as a beacon of hope, a reassurance that, despite the tumult, all would be well. Encouraged by my sister-in-law, I initially shared these insights and poems on a Facebook page of the same name, where they resonated with a community of souls navigating their own spiritual journeys. The entries in this book are both a reflection of those initial musings and a testament to the evolution of my spiritual understanding. They are reshaped and expanded to echo the growth of my soul's voice over the intervening years, incorporating both the original insights and new revelations that speak to the breadth of my spiritual journey. Life, in its relentless march, continued to sculpt my spirit through trials and tribulations. From the loss of my home and the transient nature of rental living, to the physical ordeal of ulcerative colitis, the transition to medical retirement after more than a quarter of a century in the police service, the ebb and flow of friendships, the spectre of homelessness, and the poignant loss of my mum to cancer. All these experiences have woven the rich, complex tapestry of my existence. I share these facets of my journey not from a pedestal of unchallenged tranquility, but from the trenches of lived experience, from the heart of someone who has walked through the fire and emerged transformed. The blessings and poems within these pages are the distillation of the wisdom gleaned from the crucible of life's challenges, reflections of the spiritual awakening that has been both my companion and my healer. It is with a spirit of profound humility and hope that I extend these insights to you, dear reader. May they serve as lanterns on your path, illuminating the way through the dark passages of your own journey. May they remind you that within every challenge lies the seed of a blessing waiting to be discovered. Through the prism of these pages, I invite you to view your own experiences through a lens of transformation and grace, to embrace the alchemy of the soul that transmutes pain into wisdom, and to find, nestled within the folds of life's trials, your own blessing in disguise. Blessing 1. Good luck, bad luck, who knows? In the labyrinth of life's experiences, Eastern philosophy offers a profound paradox that challenges our conventional perceptions of fortune and misfortune, encapsulated in the adage, good luck, bad luck, who knows? This concept, emblematic of the yin and yang, serves as a reminder of the intricate balance that governs our existence, where within every adversity lies the seed of a blessing, and within every blessing the shadow of potential adversity. It underscores the fluid nature of life circumstances, suggesting the essence of our experiences is not fixed, but ever-changing, coloured by the perspectives we choose to adopt. William Shakespeare, in his timeless wisdom, mirrors this sentiment in his poem As You Like It, illustrating how adversity, though venomous and ugly like the toad, can bear precious jewels. He writes, "Sweet are the uses of adversity, which, like the toad, ugly and venomous, wears yet a precious jewel in its head, and this our life, exempt from public haunt, find tongues in trees, books in the running brooks, sermons in stones, and good in everything." Shakespeare invites us to find beauty and value in the trials we endure, proposing that adversity is not merely an obstacle to be overcome, but a teacher, a guide that leads us to uncover the profundity and richness embedded in the fabric of life. This perspective echoes the Eastern understanding of duality, where every aspect of existence is interwoven with its opposite, each given meaning and context to the other. The yin and yang symbol, a representation of this fundamental duality, encapsulates the harmony of opposites, demonstrating how light and darkness, joy and sorrow, success and failure are intrinsically connected. It teaches us that life's experiences are not to be categorized simplistically as good or bad, but to be embraced in their totality, recognizing the potential for growth and enlightenment inherent in every moment. This symbol serves as a visual testament to the balance that permeates the universe, reminding us that the flow of life encompasses all, moving in cycles and seasons, each with its lessons and gifts. At the heart of this philosophy lies the understanding that our attitude towards life unfolding drama plays a pivotal role in shaping our experience of it. When faced with challenges, our perception determines whether we see them as insurmountable obstacles or opportunities for growth. Similarly, in moments of victory, our attitude dictates whether we remain humble and open to the lessons of success or become ensnared by the trappings of achievement. It is our mindset, our chosen frame of reference, that imbues our experiences with meaning, transforming the mundane into the miraculous, the painful into the powerful. Viktor Frankl, a Holocaust survivor and author of the book Man's Search for Meaning, wrote of this ability to choose one's attitude. Quote, "Everything can be taken from a man but one thing, the last of human freedoms, to choose one's attitude in given set of circumstances, to choose one's own way." Unquote. The wisdom of good luck, bad luck, who knows, encourages a stance of openness, curiosity, and non-attachment towards life's vicissitudes. It invites us to relinquish our tight grip on expectations and outcomes, to flow with the currents of change with grace and flexibility. By adopting this perspective, we learn to appreciate the transient nature of all things, finding peace in the understanding that both joy and sorrow are but temporary visitors in the grand scheme of our existence. As the ancient Persian adage reminds us, this too shall pass. This approach to life cultivates a deep sense of resilience and equanimity, enabling us to navigate the highs and lows with a steady heart and a clear mind. It teaches us to extract wisdom from every experience, to see the hidden blessings in adversity, and to remain vigilant to the lessons cloaked in success. In doing so, we align ourselves with the fundamental truths of the universe, embracing the dance of duality with open arms and a courageous heart. Moreover, this philosophy offers a pathway to compassion and empathy, as we recognize that just as we are subject to the ebb and flow of fortune, so too are those around us. It fosters a sense of connectedness, a realization that we are all participants in this shared journey of life, each with our own battles and triumphs, each with our own stories of resilience and transformation. In the embrace of good luck, bad luck, who knows, we find a powerful antidote to the rigidity of judgment and the pain of resistance. We learn to meet life with a sense of wonder and acceptance, to find serenity in the face of uncertainty, and to trust in the unfolding of our journey, knowing that within every moment lies the potential for growth, learning, and transcendence. Thus, as we traverse the varied landscape of our lives, let us carry with us the wisdom of the East and the insight of Shakespeare, finding tongues in trees, books in running brooks, sermons in stones, and good in everything. Let us remember that the true measure of our fortune lies not in the external circumstances we encounter, but the quality of our response to them, in our ability to discern harmony, grace, and purpose in the fabric of life. A poem, Blessings in Disguise. She hides her face in darkness and calls upon the light to find you in your darkest hour, weakened by the fight. Her hand outstretched to lift you up from down on bended knee, a stranger or a friend not known, her face you cannot see. Life's journey takes you on its ride where fear and sorrow have its place, at times so overwhelming you doubt God's loving grace. Hold the faith that she will find you, be certain she'll arrive. There is no soul upon this earth whose heart she will deprive. The call goes out from wounded hearts filled with such despair, to send to you an angel's love in answer to your prayer. Look behind the loss you mourn into the empty space, for there you'll find her blessing stand right there in its place. She brings to you the strength within to rise again with each new day, to start afresh, a second chance to meet all trials that come your way. What she knows is not revealed until the perfect time. That blessing in your fate awaits, together they're entwined. From the dust of fallen stars, new dreams arise from deep within. Her hand in yours inspires you on to try life once again. Be filled with love and faith that she sends from God to you. Never doubt for one single day your dreams will all come true. Look deep within the eyes of that soul you greet today. Listen, oh so carefully, to what they do or say. For behind the mask they wear, you may well be surprised, the person that you least expect is your blessing in disguise. Blessing 2. Perfect Imperfection. Spun within the complex web of life, interwoven with innumerable aspirations, desires, and dreams, there lies a persistent and often elusive quest for perfection. This pursuit, deeply ingrained from the earliest moments of our existence, shadows our every step, whispering promises of fulfillment that remain just beyond reach. As I once penned in a poem, "Do not seek from me perfection, because I'll surely let you down." There lies an acknowledgement of our inherent fallibility and futility of chasing an ideal that by its nature is unattainable. From the initial cry that announces our arrival into the world to the final whisper of our departure, society imposes on us a standard of perfection that seems not only daunting, but fundamentally at odds with the essence of our being. Through academic achievements, professional milestones, and even the accolades that celebrate our supposed superiority, we're taught to value ourselves and others through the lens of this unrelenting expectation. Yet beneath this veneer of achievement and recognition lies a more insidious effect, the internalization of a belief that our worth is contingent upon meeting these external benchmarks of success. Nowhere is this quest for perfection more poignant and damaging than in the realm of our closest relationships. In seeking flawlessness from those we hold dear, a partner, a friend, sibling, or even the divine, we unwittingly set the stage for disappointment and disillusionment. This relentless scrutiny, this measurement of worth against an idealized standard, can lead us to overlook the beauty of the imperfect bonds that make our lives rich and meaningful. This same relentless pursuit extends its reach into every corner of our lives, from the ceaseless striving for a more beautiful home to the dissatisfaction that takes our professional endeavors and travel experiences. The pervasive culture of critique and comparison, fueled by ratings and reviews, perpetuates a cycle of discontent and complaining, forever chasing a mirage of perfection that dances just out of our grasp. Yet as the years gather and pursuit wearies, a profound realization dawns that the standard of perfection we sought was a chimera, an illusion that led us away from the very essence of life's beauty. The question then arises, who deemed perfection the pinnacle of achievement? Who decided that it was the standard by which we should all be measured? In the serene beauty of Japanese culture, influenced by the deep wells of Buddhist philosophy, we find the concept of wabi-sabi, a celebration of the beauty found in impermanence, imperfection, and incompleteness. This ancient wisdom, a quiet yet powerful rebellion against the tyranny of perfection, offers a lens through which to view the universe not in spite of its flaws, but because of them. Wabi-sabi invites us to embrace the paradox that it is the imperfection of the cosmos that renders it truly perfect. What then can wabi-sabi teach the West about relinquishing the unyielding grip of perfectionism? How can this philosophy guide us to a place of acceptance and appreciation for the beauty inherent in the flawed and the unfinished? By adopting the principles of wabi-sabi, we learn to view our relationships and our lives through a lens of compassion and understanding. We begin to see the cracks and rough edges not as blemishes to be corrected, but as marks of character and authenticity. In this shift of perception, we discover the freedom to love without condition, to appreciate the new beauty of moment of each being without the distortion of impossible standards. The journey towards embracing imperfection is not merely an aesthetic choice, but a profound spiritual awakening. It is an acknowledgement that the essence of life, in all its messy and glorious reality, is a canvas of constant evolution, never complete, never perfect, but always beautiful in its impermanence. As we navigate the path of life, let us carry with us the wisdom of wabi-sabi, allowing it to illuminate the richness of the imperfect, the transient, and the incomplete. In doing so, we open our hearts to the true perfection that lies in acceptance, in the recognition of our shared humanity, and in the celebration of the divinely flawed tapestry of existence. Let perfect imperfection be our mantra, a guiding light towards a life lived in full color, unafraid of the shadows, and enriched by the very imperfections that make us beautifully human. In this embrace of the imperfect, we find not only peace, but a deeper, more authentic connection to ourselves, to others, and to the universe itself. Blessing 3. Can you forgive? Do you remember those quaint desk calendars we used to have that would show a daily quote of wisdom before those digital versions took their place? The essence of wisdom they shared remains timeless. One such pearl was, "To err is human, to forgive is divine." This quote resonates deeply in the current era, compelling us to reflect on its profound simplicity and enduring truth. In the realm of human experience, the motif of forgiveness weaves through the narrative of virtually every life story. Among the myriad forms it takes, self-forgiveness stands out as a pivotal chapter. How many of us, ensnared by the shadows of past mistakes, replay them incessantly, as if our minds were stuck on a loop, unable to break free from a haunting refrain? The seductive whisper of ego convinces us there's value in nursing our grievances, in holding on to pain, as though it were a piece of our identity. But at what cost? The burden of unresolved past actions is akin to a digital screenshot of shame and guilt, meticulously archived in the recesses of our minds, awaiting some future moment of reckoning. This self-imposed sentence of carrying forward our guilt.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.